That's the first time I'm hearing this, right? Like, so I didn't aspire to be that, but I just happened to basically, like, I aspired to be somewhere, but I happened to be like go beyond that.
By the time I completed, Amazon was, I got lucky, I would say.
Nobody gets lucky, man. I think you got lucky that you gave interviews a little early. The first 2 weeks are like honeymoon period, right? Like you're kind of chilling and you don't have much of work to do. Everybody's trying to make sure that you're happy.
That initial ramp up was hard for me, at least the initial 3 4 months, because everything was new to me.
Hey everyone, this is Ankush, and so we have a little different guest, I would say, this time for our series. We have Mr. Vidya Sagar with us. Vidya Sagar is currently a SD2 at Microsoft. Before that, he was working at Amazon as a software developer, and before that, he spent close to 2.5 years at TCS. Right. So the interesting part is he did his engineering in electronics. From, I would say, more like a tier two college. So pretty decent college, but like he was in electronics, ended up at TCS and sort of decided that that's not what he would like to do, and sort of prepared to get into Amazon. And then within like 1.5 2 years, he now is at Microsoft as an SD2, right? So I think this would work like a great motivation story for a lot of you. So just wanted to have a discussion with Sagar and like get to know him a little better. Hi Vidya Sagar, welcome to Coding Ninjas.
Thanks, Ankush. Thanks for having me. And it was a very
So
nice intro.
yeah, thank you so much. So Vidya Sagar, would love to sort of know you a little better, right? Like in the sense that would love to understand why did you sort of so first of all, let's start with your college, right? Like, so you were doing electronics. Why did you decide to do engineering in electronics and not in computer science? Like, was that a calculated decision? How did that happen?
That wasn't a calculated decision, to be honest. At least in my state, the order of courses were like, first easy gets filled up and next mechanical gets filled up. So these two are the most sought out of courses, at least at my point of time in 2013. So I
Okay.
just went in with that myth. I didn't do much of research, to be honest. So that was the reason. Everyone was taking it, and that was the one which gets filled first, and that's the reason I went with it. So apart from that,
Wow.
I don't have any other reason.
Wow, that's surprising. I didn't know that that is the case. Your state is Tamil Nadu, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Right. Okay. That's very interesting. So okay. So let's say that everybody in your state sort of likes to go to electronics first. So you went into electronics. Like, how was college? Like, did you enjoy electronics? What was the process like? How were the 4 years like? Did you do a lot of programming or not? Like, what was those 4 years like?
So I didn't do much of coding, and the electronic subjects were pretty, vast, I would say, because they can ask anything. If you study theory, they can ask problems, and if you study problems, they would ask derivations. So it's kind of like a mix and match, and it's a big headache, I would say. So I didn't
Okay.
like much of easy, to be honest, but it was okay. It was fairly decent. And I didn't do much of coding. I had two coding classes, one in C and other in C++ in my first and second sem, but that was just basics. Data structures
Right.
wasn't touched. Anything wasn't touched. So it was just pretty basic stuff.
Okay. So, like, how did you land up at TCS? Like, did you try to go to some ECU like core companies, or did you sort of decided that that's not something that you want to do and you want to explore computer science? Like, what was the thought process at? Like, how did you land up at TCS?
I didn't think about much about what these are the companies I want and stuff like that. College was pretty chill for me. I
Okay.
just went, and I didn't study that much, or I didn't have much aspirations at that point of time. So I just went in with, okay, let's get placed in some company, and that's how TCS happened. So a good number of colleges do come to a good number of companies do come to my college, including top tier companies like Microsoft, PayPal. Everyone do come, but it was pretty much branch restricted or CGPA restricted, heavily CGPA restricted at that point. So if you're, what I mean to say is, suppose if you're from ECE, then you need to have a 9 point plus, Or if you're from CS, then a 7-point plus would be fine. So that those were the restrictions at that point. So I didn't have 9-point plus or anywhere close. So I didn't have much of choice, or I didn't know coding also. So TCS was one company which was, you know, which I attended and I got it. So that was the thinking at that point of time.
Yeah, I don't think you would like my question, but what was your GPA?
It's 6.5.
Okay. 6.54. So perfect. So now, so you got a job at TCS. You decided, you joined TCS. Now, what was your first, like, what was your initial experience like, right? Like now, you haven't done much programming, but you are now in a program. I'm assuming it was a programming job. So now you are in programming. So what was the initial experience like? When did you sort of decide this is not what you want to do and you want to like aspire for bigger companies or like better, I would say better companies or different companies? What was the time at TCS like?
So TCS was pretty good experience, I would say. For the first, they have this initial training period, which was pretty chill, I would say. It's pretty good. And after the 1.5 years, I didn't face any issues. Like I was put into a kind of like a support project, I would say. I was put as a database administrator where I got to learn many database concepts, which helped me till now. So it was a pretty good experience. The work-life balance was pretty good. And it was a great experience, I would say. I wouldn't say anything else otherwise. Right. So it was good. I think everyone has to go through that, and it's pretty nice.
Okay. So when did you decide that you want to move from TCS, like you want to go to like a company like Amazon, which obviously has a pretty different bar, right, in terms of if you want to get into TCS, if you want to get into Amazon, the bar is very, very different. So I'm sure like everybody working at TCS at some level, they do want to sort of upgrade in terms of the kind of company they are at, right? So when did you sort of decide that you want to do that and you want to aspire for something like Amazon and not like some more like in a mid-tier, like a little more, I would say a different service-based company or like a different, like you want to aspire for Amazon. So what was the purpose of that?
So, okay, to be completely honest, I didn't aspire for Amazon. I just wanted to start my prep and kick off something and do something else. There are a few companies in my hometown, which is what I initially wanted in my career. Okay. I just wanted to be at home and go to those companies and come back. So that was my aspiration at that point. Later on, I prepared too much and I came to a point where, you know, I came too far and I cannot go back. So at that point, I started applying to Amazon and other all of these tech companies. And that's how Amazon happened. To be completely honest, I didn't want like, you know, that company name or, you know, that package, I would say, to be completely honest.
So how did you, that's the first time I'm hearing this, right? Like, so I didn't aspire to be that, but I just happened to basically, like I aspired to be somewhere, but I happened to be like, go beyond that. And I couldn't come back from there. So like, what does that even mean? Right? Like, I'm sure you started preparing and you could have stopped at some level, but you sort of, you're saying that you just kept going and like you reached a place where you couldn't come back from.
One of the reasons is those two companies, right? The ones which are my hometown, they rejected me. So I had to keep preparing and that's how it happened, to be completely frank.
Right. So what was their process like? What were they looking for in your profile that you couldn't sort of get in?
Actually, those failures helped me a lot, I would say, because they asked pretty standard data structures, algorithms, questions only. But I wasn't prepared at that point of time. And I was midway through the course, I would say. Like, I took the Python basics and data structures course from Coding Users. And I was just, you know, halfway through at that point. I didn't come to linked list and all, and I was asked a linked list question. So that was like, you know, okay, I need to complete this course and then only I can, you know, start to give interviews. And that took time. And by the time I completed, Amazon was, you know, I got lucky, I would say.
Nobody gets lucky, man. I think you got lucky that you gave interviews a little early. And you got rejected by those two companies, so you basically sort of aspired for a little higher, right? Perfect. So so you're saying that you sort of wanted to prepare for DS Algo and you sort of learned it from CN and like did it in Python. One question that a lot of people have is that did it, like having done it in Python, was that a problem? Like did Amazon see it as a problem? Did they want you to do it in C++, Java, or were they okay with Python?
No, I don't think any, like, you know, at least from big tech point of view, I don't think any company looks for a language oriented approach, because any language can be picked up by a good developer within like 10 to 15 days. It's just a matter of syntax, and which a lot of IDEs already help you. So they go more about the logic and how clean our code looks and, you know, how efficient it runs, and language wasn't a constraint, I would say. Python did help me initially, at least, because it has a simpler syntax, and, you know, a lot of backend things are handled by itself, and we don't need to do much about it. So that helped me a lot with Python, I would say.
Okay. So when you applied for Amazon, like, what was the process like? And within that process, was that a problem that you were in TCS right now? Was that seen as a not that great experience? Like, what was that like?
So how I got the Amazon interview was, this was pre-COVID times. So Amazon used to have these drives for SD1 in my hometown in a particular college. So there would be a drive link that would be circulated, a Google Drive link. You just fill your email ID and upload your resume, and everyone would get an invite. And as soon as you reach that place, an online assessment would take place. It's about like close to 200 to 500 people. Everyone would come because it's kind of like a walk-in. And after the first rounds, you'd be followed with three data structures rounds, two data structures and one bar raiser round. And the whole day would go in that. So if you go in at morning 8 o'clock, it would be like around night 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock by the process it ends, because a lot of people attend those interviews. Right. So that's how Amazon happened for me. I didn't apply through the portal, let's see.
And what was the interviews like? Like, they were just focused on DS Algo, or did they focus on your TCS experience, your projects? Like, what was that like?
They do ask about the projects and what our works look like. And if the person also knows about the domain, then you can expect like one or two questions. But the major focus is on data structures and algorithms and problem solving.
Okay. So how was the experience at Amazon? Like, and how was it different from TCS?
It was great, I would say. Like, you know, getting into these companies is one thing. Then, you know, meeting the bar there, that's a different play. Because you'd be working with the best. And that initial ramp up was hard for me, at least the initial 3-4 months, because everything was new to me. And the way Amazon moves and TCS moves, it's totally two different paces. And switching gears was hard for me, but initially. And then later on, you know, I stopped fearing, like, you know, new technologies and new tech stacks. And it just became like, you know, it's nothing. I just need to go through the documentation, look for what I want, implement a small project on one, and then implement it on my bigger code base. So once I got used to that, things became very smooth. But getting used to that takes time. And all the engineers at Amazon also were supportive of that, knowing my background. And, you know, they do take that into consideration and help you out. So that was my experience.
Okay. And when did you sort of decide that you want to try Microsoft, or like, why did you decide, and like, how did that happen?
Okay. So in Amazon, I was just an Android developer. There was not much of backend or other tech stacks which I work on. So I started looking based upon that factor. I am okay with Android, but I just wanted to at least explore other options, and I felt like I was ready for a new challenge. So that's why I started looking out from Amazon.
Okay. And how was the process at Microsoft?
Microsoft, I was referred, and then as soon as I referred, I got an online coding link. They have a platform called Codility. So that was the first round, like a screening round. And then after that, I had one data structures round, two low-level plus high-level design rounds, and final hiring manager round. So all of it was good. It was just more focused on design, because you grow on experience, your design skills matter as much as DSA. So that was the experience.
And now, like, at Microsoft, is it also Android, or is it more on the back end?
I'm yet to know. It's been 2 weeks. I'm yet to know about it.
Okay.
And I don't mind even if it's just Android. It's fine, yeah. I would say.
So I'm not going to ask you how's your experience at Microsoft so far. I'm sure it has been amazing. The first 2 weeks are like honeymoon period, right? Like you're and you don't have much of work to do. Everybody's trying to make sure that you're happy and you're sort of welcome. So I'm sure that's
you're having a good time.
So it's supposed to be Microsoft, which office? Like it's in Hyderabad?
Hyderabad one. Hyderabad, yeah.
Yeah, it's a nice city. I spent like a year working in Amazon in Hyderabad when I went out of college back in 2008. Yeah, so I'm in Hyderabad. Mm-hmm. It's a nice place.
Cool.
Perfect, man. Thank you so much. This was really helpful. And I think this is going to, the idea of sort of talking to you was that we have a lot of students who sort of don't realize sometimes that they need to sort of get into coding a little earlier, and eventually, like you said, they apply to all the companies and they end up at a lot of times decide to join TCS, Infosys, or some other service company which they are not super excited about, and like, but they really want to know that whether now, like, can they move to something else or not, or is this something that they are to sort of continue. So just want to talk to you and sort of let everybody know that this is a perfect example of how somebody sort of without any programming background like went into TCS, and then basically I am guessing like you spent like 6-7 months learning data structural algorithm through the course, right? That will be
Definitely close to 10 months to get a strong hold of, you know, right. I don't freak out when I see a new question. So it took 10 months for that. I study slowly.
That's okay. I think like along with the job, it does take more time, and taking like 8 to 10 months and then basically completely changing the path of your career, right? That's a brilliant sort of amazing 10 months that you will always remember, that's the 10 months that changed the path for you. Perfect. Thank you so much. I'm sure a lot of people will get inspired by this story. And thank you so much for coming and taking out time for this.
And no issues, Sanjish. It's my pleasure. So, yeah, coding this also has helped me a lot, because by that point, I had tried multiple online resources. Nothing was working out. And I was waiting for your first fully English course, and you let your Python course. And I believe it was the second batch, and I took it ASAP. So,
okay.
I was looking out for that, and
Yeah, so I think like we do a lot of students do complain that why do we have so many courses in Hindi. Although that being said, now we do have most of our courses in English as well. So hopefully that's not a complaint that we have to hear now. Perfect. Thank you so much. And bye-bye, man.
Thanks, Ankush. Bye-bye.